Today I'm going to talk about major minor cross matching. Materials required for cross matching will be donor and recipient blood samples collected in EDTA and serum separation tube respectively, 0.9% normal saline and plain tubes without anticoagulant. You may also require a centrifuge, incubator, a microscope, clean glass slides, pipette tips, etc. Collect the samples and mark them respectively. Invert the test tube several times to check for clots. After checking, they are good to go for centrifugation. If the sample is submitted in serum separation tubes, then you need to centrifuge it for 4 minutes. While the centrifugation is going on, start marking the test tubes. Any sort of clean test tube can be used for RBC washing. Take 4 clean glass test tubes and start marking them as follows. Donor blood recipient serum as major, recipient blood donor serum as minor. Donor control will have donor blood and donor serum. Recipient control will have recipient blood and recipient serum respectively. Start separating plasma after centrifugation. Plasma can be separated and transferred into a plain test tubes. The packed cells in the lowermost bottom will be taken for erythrocyte washing. Start separating the serum from donor sample and transfer it to tubes that are named as minor and donor control respectively. Because both minor and donor control requires donor serum or plasma. Similarly, start transferring recipient serum into donor and recipient control tubes. After filling serum in all the test tubes, leave them aside. And let's start processing the RBCs. Here is where we require 0.9% normal saline. Take the tubes that are previously marked as donor RBC and recipient RBC separately. Take around 200 microliter of packed RBCs and transfer them to tubes separately. After transferring, add about 4.8 ml of 0.9% normal saline to the same test tubes. Invert the tube several times to mix the RBCs with normal saline properly. Once both the donor and recipient RBCs are mixed with normal saline, start with centrifugation. Centrifuge the samples for 1 minute. After centrifugation, discard the supernatant. Supernatant can be discarded either by decanting or pipetting out. Repeat RBC washing with normal saline 2 more times. After the third RBC washing, gently pipette out the supernatant from both the test tubes. And make final RBC suspension with normal saline. Invert the tube several times. Now they are ready for cross matching. Take donor RBC, pipette out 200 microliter and add it to the major test tube. Add the same to the donor control. Similarly, pipette out 200 microliter of recipient blood and transfer it into minor test tube and recipient control tubes. After adding donor and recipient samples, it is time for incubation. Incubation time is around 37 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes or 30 minutes at room temperature. Here I am setting the timer for 15 minutes because I am incubating at 37 degrees Celsius. After incubation, take out our samples and centrifuge for 1 minute. After centrifugation, examine the supernatant for hemolysis. Start pipetting out the supernatant until you have very little supernatant left behind. Start mixing blood and plasma and keep a drop on examination slides. Look for gross agglutination. If you don't see any, then proceed with microscopic examination by adding a cover slip. And finally, this is how a compatible samples will look like. You can see individual RBCs that are not clumping with each other. This is how an incompatible sample will look like under microscope. If you see RBC clumping either in major or minor or in both, then they are not fit for transfusion. Agglutination can be differentiated from rolo formation by adding a drop of normal saline. Rolo formation will get disintegrated in normal saline, whereas agglutination will remain the same. Hope this video was useful. If you liked it, make sure you subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye.